People, welcome to Edupedia World 9th Grade Computer Applications Video Lecture Series. I'm Upeka Wendibona and today we learn how to install and uninstall a software. So for that I'm using Windows 7 operating system and Notepad++ to demonstrate software installation and uninstallation process. First of all, I'll tell you what is Notepad++. It's a free text editor and source code editor that you can download easily from the website. Unlike the built-in text editor in Windows, the Notepad, this editor supports syntax highlighting as well as support programming to somewhat extent. Well, actually, this is not an IDE to build up applications, but to learn programming language. So for our 6, 7 and 8 sections, we plan to use Notepad++ to code Java. So now I'll show you where we can freely obtain the software. Just search on the Google Notepad++ and there you can find their website notepad-plus-plus.org. Click on the link download in the left side panel. The current version of Notepad++ is 6.9. By clicking the download button in here, you can download the installer of Notepad++. So here is the installer of the Notepad++ that I had downloaded. To run the installer, simply double click the .exe file. As the first step, it asks from your language, as it supports several languages apart from English. When you select a language, there comes the welcome page of the setup guide. It shows the basic information about the application. So here it says, setup will guide you through the installation of Notepad++ version 6.9. It is recommended that you close all other applications before starting setup. This will make it possible to update relevant system files without having to reboot your computer. I'm not considering that part because we are not going to use this application right now. So if you are planning to use this application without a rebooting, you need to close other applications. After clicking the next button, it will show you the license agreement. You need to review the license term before installing the application. It's a long document, so you have to go through and read this. You have to agree with this license agreement to install the application. If you accept the terms, you can click the I agree button to continue the process. Then you have to choose a location to install the application. Here it mentions what is the space required by this application and also it mentions what is the space available in the drive. So I'm not going to install it under the C drive, I'm going to install it under the E drive. The next step is to select the component you need to install with the Notepad++ application. I'm not going to change any of these feature checkboxes. You can see when you check or uncheck a feature, the space required is changing. You can see a description of each feature when you point your mouse pointer into the each feature. So after selecting the features that you needed, you can click the next button. The final step is to mention whether you need a shortcut in the desktop for the Notepad++ application or not. I needed a shortcut in the desktop, so I'm going to tick the checkbox. And I'm not interested about the other options provided in here, so I'm going to click the install button. By clicking the show details button, you can see what are the files copied into our installation location. And this green progress bar describes how the installation process is going on. After extracting all the files into our installation location, you will receive the completion message. It says Notepad++ version 6.9 has been installed on your computer. You can tick this checkbox to run the Notepad++ after clicking the finish button. You can untick this option to avoid launching the application. So I will keep the ticked checkbox in here to launch the application to show you what is Notepad++. As you see, it is a simple text editor, but not like built-in Notepad. Notepad++ supports programming languages and highlight the syntaxes. We will come into that part at the final three sections, where we need to code Java. So now we know how to install an application. What we have followed are the general features in the installation process. For almost all of the applications, we need to follow these steps. Selecting a language and reading the license agreement, then selecting the features you need to install, and selecting a location to install, likewise. Some applications come as installers where you need to install the application, but some applications come as portable applications. So for portable applications, you do not need to install the application on your hard drive. You can launch the application by simply clicking the file it provided. Anyway, what we were interested was how to install an application. And now we know how to install an application. Next thing we need to learn is how to uninstall an application. So for that, you have to go to Control Panel. To open the Control Panel, click the Start button and from the Start menu, click the Control Panel. Programs category, select the uninstall a program link. So from this place you can uninstall a program or change or repair a program. To change or repair an application, the application should be capable to change or being repaired. Most of the applications doesn't provide those capabilities. They are only capable to being uninstalled. But applications like Microsoft Office package, it can be changed or repaired. So in the list in here, it mentions all the applications that are installed in our machine. So we are going to uninstall the application that we had just installed, Notepad++. So the applications are now in the alphabetical order. So just go for the letter N. And you can see the Notepad++ application in there. Right-click the application and then select Uninstall as Change. It again asks you what language you needed for the instructions. So I'm selecting English and proceed for the further step. So here it says Notepad++ version 6.9 will be uninstalled from the following folder, the installation location we have provided in the installation process, and it says click uninstall to start the uninstallation. So I'm clicking uninstall button. By clicking the show details button, you can view what files are being removed. And this progress bar describes the progress of the uninstallation process. So after necessary files being deleted, it will gives you the completed message. After clicking the close button, you can see here now in the list, the Notepad++ is gone. It uninstalled. No longer they are in the machine. So that's how the uninstallation process is going on. Not difficult as the installation process. That's all we needed to do in this lecture. So let's summarize what we have done today. In a typical installation process, most of the applications ask what language the instruction need to be. English language comes as the default language, but if you needed any other, you can select one. Next come the welcome screen and it mentions about the version of the application you are going to install and other relevant information. Then you have to read a long document called license agreement. It mentions the terms and conditions you need to be agreed to install the application. Then you have to mention the installation path. It will gives you the required space it needed to install the application. So the drive you mentioned should be capable to take that capacity. If the application can be customized, which means you can select the features it provided, you can do it in the installation process. Some applications ask for the scope. That means a machine can be accessed by multiple users. So it asks whether every user that uses this machine needed the software, or the user that is going to install the software is just only the user of the application. In the Notepad++ installation process, we didn't come across that kind of scope mentioning because it installed for all the users. And the final step most oftenly is the shortcut creation. So here you can mention that you needed a shortcut in the desktop. And then you need to give your confirmation to start the installation, because some may need to go back and change the settings that have provided. So after giving the confirmation, there is no way to going back. This installation process is shown with a progress bar, so you can understand how much time will take it to the end. Some applications shows what kind of files being extracted and copied into the installation file location in this installation process. And at the end, it will gives you the success message, and there you can define whether you need to launch the application right now or just simply close the setup process. So that's about the installation process. If we look at the uninstallation process, to uninstall the application, you need to go to the control panel. So from the uninstall programs control panel window, we can uninstall a program. The first step is to select the language for the instruction, and then it will ask for the confirmation to uninstall the application. This uninstallation process will be shown with a progress bar, so you can get the idea of the speed and how long it will take to uninstall the application. And at the end, you will receive the success message, and also you can view the files which have been deleted. So that's all about installing and uninstalling an application. We covered up everything in the first section for operating systems. So from the next episode, we can start the second section, Internet and World Wide Web. So thank you for watching. See you again in the next lecture. This video brought to you by edupediaworld.com. Watch more from our website.